Hi everyone, can you please tell me if I'm audible and visible both? Please give me a thumbs up if you think I'm audible and visible both. Yes, thank you. Thank you, Mulai, for the confirmation. So, to introduce myself, I am Dr. Resham Prasani, the educator in the subject of dermatology on an academy. I am a practicing dermatologist at Matunga, Mumbai, and I am also associated with the BT Wadia Hospitals for Children. I was associated with the KJ Soumya Medical College for 10 years before I joined an academy. So, to introduce to you the plus subscription of an academy. So, this plus subscription of the an academy has an advantage that it gives you daily live classes, structured courses, live tests and quizzes, as well as an unlimited access to all the content of an academy, whether it is recorded or whether it is live. Okay. Apart from that, also, you should be aware of the Iconic subscription of an academy. So, Iconic is kind of a combo of both an academy and prep ladder. So, through an academy, you get the live classes, batch courses, live tests, and quizzes. While through prep ladder, you get the video lectures, question bank series, and rapid revision courses. Okay, so you should be aware that there is a limited time offer on the Iconic subscription, which is a combo of an academy and prep ladder. So earlier, if say for example, if you are paying for 18 months, earlier you would pay 66,000, but now you will have to pay only 45,000. Okay, and if earlier for 12 months you were paying 55,000, now you will have to pay just 40,500. Okay, so this is a very good offer, and the code that you need to use for subscription to this particular offer is MENTOR, MENTOR. MENTOR is the code that you will use to have an access to this offer, and please hurry up because this particular offer is available only for the first 500 students. So also you should be aware that there is an amazing offer where you buy for 3 months, the subscription you will buy for 3 months and you will get for 3 plus 1. That is, you will get 1 month extra free, and that 1 month will be credited within the first 30 days. Please use the code MENTOR. MENTOR is the code that you will use to get a subscription for this offer. Also, to appraise you of the ongoing batches on an academy, on 28th of April, there is a batch which has started, which is called as the NEET PG Season 1 batch. So, the 19 subjects are kind of divided and they are tailored to the new requirement of the delayed and the postponed NEET PG 2021 exam. So, you have your Season 1, which is between April 21st to May 11th. Where there will be case-based high-yield topic revision. Then there is Season 2, which is between May 12th to May 18th, where there will be an image-based revision. And Season 3 is May 19th to May 30th, there will be test and analysis, as well as there will be grand tests. There is an INI MCQ marathon batch, which starts off on 28th of April. Okay, so there are going to be subject-wise discussions followed by solutions, 3 grand tests for maximum practice, and there will be rapid revisions of all the high-yield topics with interactive classes with the educators. So, for all this, what you need to do is to download the An Academy Learning app, which is available on iOS and on the Android platforms. Okay, what you need to do is you can go in either for the plus subscription, which would cost you around 1,625 a month for a period of 18 months, or you can go in for the Iconic subscription, which will cost you around 58,500 total. That will be 1,625 per month for 36 months, and you get an extra 10% off when you use the code MENTOR. MENTOR is the code which you need to use to access all the discounts. Okay, So, with that, let's begin with our session for today. Okay, so already, please give me a thumbs up. Yes, so the first question. A patient presented with discolored anesthetic skin, ulcers on the soles of the feet, dry skin, and loss of eyelashes. The microbiologist is using an animal as shown in the image for isolating the cause of organism. You need to identify this animal. What do you think is the answer? Look at the animal very carefully. And you need to tell me what is your answer. Is it an albino mice, guinea pig, hamster, or is it a nine-banded armadillo? Yes, so Tina, Divya, Santrupta, Eva, Aditya, Divya, all of you are correct. It is the nine-banded armadillo. So you can see actually those nine bands on it. Okay. These are the bands that you can see on the surface. This is nothing but the nine-banded armadillo, which is used to cultivate the Mycobacterium leprae. So the animal shown in the picture is the nine-banded armadillo, which is used to culture the Mycobacterium leprae because Mycobacterium leprae does not follow the Koch's postulates. Okay, the Indian version grows in the foot pad of the mice. Okay, so if you do not have the nine-banded armadillo, you can also grow it in the foot pad of the nude and thymectomized mice. But it is cultured, the culture on the mice is slightly difficult. So the better option is the nine-banded armadillo. So to tell you about this Mycobacterium leprae, as you know that it does not follow the Koch's postulates. So it grows best at 30 degrees Celsius. So this is 7 degrees less than a normal temperature. So that is why it has a preference for the cooler areas of the body. Okay, so which is 7 degrees below the core temperature in humans. And hence, Hansen's lesions, they tend to localize to the cooler and superficial areas of the body. So which are the cooler and superficial areas? You have involvement of the earlobes, the nose, testis, liver, superficial cooler nerves. So if they ask you which is the most common peripheral nerve to be involved in Hansen's disease, it is the ulnar nerve. And if they tell you what is the most common cranial nerve to be involved in Hansen's disease, then the answer is facial nerve. Okay, so because these are superficial nerves, so that is why they are cooler nerves, and that is why this Mycobacterium leprae grows much better in these nerves. So it can be cultivated in armadillo, but also in the foot pads of the mice, nude and thymectomized mice. PGL1 is a unique glycolipid on the surface of the bacillus, and it contributes to the pathogenesis. The doubling time again is an MCQ, so please remember the doubling time of Mycobacterium leprae is 11 to 13 days, the average being 12 days. Okay, so what have we learned from this slide? One, that Mycobacterium leprae has an affinity towards the cooler structures of the body. As a corollary to this, you can know that the most common cranial nerve to be involved is facial, most common peripheral nerve to be involved is ulnar. So also, the most common deformity that you see in Hansen's disease is the ulnar claw hand. Okay. So this, as a corollary, you can understand that it usually spares the deeper and warmer structures. So CNS is very less involved in leprosy, very, very rarely involved in leprosy. Okay. Also, the uterus and the ovaries, they are also very, very rarely involved in Hansen's disease. Okay. Now, all clear? Can we go on to the next question? Yes. Let's go on to the next question. You have a known case of psoriasis, okay? And he has fingernail involvement, which is appearing as punctate pitting, onycholysis, nail thickening, or subungual hyperkeratosis. How many of these patients of psoriasis show these changes? Whether it is all, one third, one half, or two third? Anyone can come up with an answer? What percentage or how many cases of psoriasis will show nail changes? All, one third, one half, or two third? Okay, so C is the correct answer, where you see that one half of all the patients are going to show the presence of nail changes. One half of all the patients of psoriasis are going to show the changes. So, nail involvement is seen in all types of psoriasis. Okay, you can see it in association with all types of psoriasis, and it is frequently present with psoriatic arthropathy. So, please remember that whenever you have nail involvement in psoriasis, it makes you more predisposed. Okay? It makes you more predisposed to psoriatic arthropathy. Santrupt asks me, salmon patch on the nail or nail pitting more specific? Santrupt, nail pitting is the most common manifestation of nail psoriasis. Okay, it is not the most specific manifestation. The most specific manifestation of nail psoriasis is the salmon patch, also which is called as the oil drop sign. Okay, so Santrupt, the answer to your question is that nail pitting is most common, while most specific is the salmon patch on the nail. Okay, so nail involvement, please remember, is seen in one half of the patients having psoriasis, and they can have involvement as punctate pitting. Now, remember, the pitting in psoriasis, it is irregular, it is deep, okay, and it is called as thimble pitting of the nail or thimble nails. Okay, so they can appear as punctate pits. Onycholysis, what is onycholysis? Onycholysis is the separation of the nail plate from the underlying nail bed. There can be thickening of the nail, or there can be subungual hyperkeratosis. About 5 to 10% of patients with psoriasis have associated arthralgias, and these are most often found in patients with fingernail involvement. Okay, now, so this is nail psoriasis. What do you see here? You can see that this is pitting. So pitting is the most common manifestation of nail psoriasis. The pits are classically random, they are deep, and they are irregular. Okay, so that is called as thimble pitting. What is the cause of the pits? The cause of the pits is the psoriatic involvement of the proximal nail matrix. So you can, so here you should know that pitting can occur in multiple conditions, not only in psoriasis. Pitting can occur in patients with alopecia areata. But if you have to differentiate between the pitting and alopecia areata versus in nail psoriasis, in patients with alopecia areata, the pitting is regular. Okay, it is, in violent psoriasis, the pitting is irregular. In alopecia areata, there is a grid pattern. Okay, so there is regular horizontal and vertical pitting causing a grid pattern in alopecia areata. In alopecia areata, the pitting is superficial, while in psoriasis, the pitting is deep. Also, you should know that the pitting in alopecia areata is called as the Scotch plaid pattern. Okay, it is called as the Scotch plaid pattern, while in patients with psoriasis, the pitting is irregular, it is a thimble nail, there are deep pits. Okay, so remember, nail pitting is the most common feature of nail psoriasis, and it happens because of involvement of the proximal nail matrix. Now, as Santrupt was asking, oil drop sign or the salmon patch. Okay, what is the oil drop sign or the salmon patch? It is a translucent yellow-red colored patch which is situated under the nail plate, and it resembles as if there is an oil drop which is placed under the nail bed. This particular sign is pathognomic of nail psoriasis. Okay, so it is pathognomic of nail psoriasis is what you need to remember. Also, there is subungual hyperkeratosis. What is subungual? Sub means below, ungual means nail. So below the nail plate, there is accumulation of keratin material. Okay, so this is subungual hyperkeratosis. Okay, now remember that subungual hyperkeratosis can be seen in patients with onychomycosis as well as it can be seen in patients having nail psoriasis. But the difference is that in patients having nail psoriasis, there is no tunneling, while in patients having onychomycosis, there is tunneling. What is tunneling? The tunneling is the effort taken by the fungus to move proximally from the distal end, right? So that is why it is seen as tunnels when you see it on the surface of the nail plate. Okay, so tunneling is not a feature of psoriasis. Tunneling is suggesting dermatophytosis. Okay, so that is how you differentiate between the subungual hyperkeratosis that happens because of psoriasis versus that happens in dermatophytosis. Okay, so tunneling is seen in dermatophytosis. Also, there is onycholysis. What is onycholysis? Onycholysis is the separation of the nail plate from the underlying nail bed, and that is because of the subungual hyperkeratosis. So, when there is accumulation of keratinous material under the nail plate, you have the separation of the nail plate from the underlying nail bed, and that is called as onycholysis. Okay, this we have already covered. Yeah, but just I'll tell you something about tracheonychia. What is tracheonychia? Tracheonychia literally means roughening of the nails. Okay, so roughened nails or roughening of the nails is seen in tracheonychia. When tracheonychia involves most of the nails of the palms and the soles, that is the fingernails as well as the toenails, then you call it as 20 nail dystrophy. Okay, so an important MCQ coming up here. The most common cause of 20 nail dystrophy is alopecia areata. Alopecia areata is the most common cause of 20 nail dystrophy. Other causes of tracheonychia or 20 nail dystrophy are psoriasis, lichen planus, and eczema. Okay, but most common is alopecia areata. Okay, now let's go to the next question. Any doubts, any questions in this particular topic, you can ask me right now. Else we move ahead. Okay, let's go to the next question. A patient complains of purplish, painless, itchy, flat bumps over the skin. What is the characteristic nail finding in the given condition? Is it pitting, pterygium, bow lines, or hyperpigmentation of the nails? Santrupt says it's pterygium. Yes, Santrupt, it is lichen planus. Anyone else? Sunshine says pterygium. Very good. Krishna says pterygium. Yes, all of you are right. The classical presentation that they have given you of painless purpuric pruritic flat bumps over the skin is suggesting lichen planus. So you know the five P's of lichen planus. The five P's of lichen planus are the lesions are purple, they are pruritic, they are plain topped. Okay, they are plain topped or flat topped. Okay, they are polygonal. They can collage to form plaques as well. ओके सो पर्पल पॉलीगोनल प्रूराइटिक प्लेन टॉप पैप्यूल्स एंड प्लैक्स इज व्हाट इज वेरी कैरेक्टरिस्टिकली डिस्क्राइब्ड फॉर लाइकन प्लेनस. ओके एंड द मोस्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक नेल फाइंडिंग इज टेरिजियम. इफ दे आस्क यू व्हाट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन फाइंडिंग ऑफ नेल लाइकन प्लेनस, कैन समबडी टेल मी व्हाट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन फाइंडिंग ऑफ नेल लाइकन प्लेनस? लाइक इन सोरासिस वी डिस्कस द मोस्ट कॉमन फीचर ऑफ नेल सोरासिस इज पिटिंग. इन द सेम फैशन व्हाट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन फीचर ऑफ लाइकन प्लेनस, ऑफ नेल लाइकन प्लेनस? एनी वन? व्हाट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन फीचर ऑफ नेल लाइकन प्लेनस? एनी वन? ओके सो आई विल टेल यू द मोस्ट कॉमन फीचर ऑफ नेल लाइकन प्लेनस इज थिनिंग ऑफ द नेल्स. ओके सो थिनिंग ऑफ द नेल्स इज द मोस्ट कॉमन फीचर ऑफ नेल लाइकन प्लेनस, बट द मोस्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक और द मोस्ट स्पेसिफिक फाइंडिंग फॉर नेल लाइकन प्लेनस इज अ नेल टेरिजियम. ओके सो व्हाट आर द फाइंडिंग्स ऑफ नेल लाइकन प्लेनस? देर कैन बी इरेग्युलर लॉन्जिट्यूडनल ग्रूविंग एंड रिजिंग ऑफ द नेल प्लेट. देर कैन बी टेरिजियम फॉर्मेशन विच इज अ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फाइंडिंग. देर कैन बी शेडिंग ऑफ द नेल प्लेट विद द एट्रोफी ऑफ द नेल बेड. देर कैन बी सबंगुअल हाइपरकेराटोसिस एंड सबंगुअल हाइपरपिगमेंटेशन. ओके What is a pterygium? Pterygium is the loss of a small area of the nail plate with proximal nail fold epidermis adherent to the nail bed epidermis. Okay, so nail pterygium is a wing-shaped deformity of the nail due to central fibrotic band which divides the nails into two parts in the proximal area. So remember, dorsal pterygium is seen in lichen planus. Okay, while ventral pterygium is seen in patients with systemic sclerosis, Raynaud's phenomenon, lupus erythematosus, and other infections. Okay, so please remember dorsal pterygium is classically seen in lichen planus, ventral pterygium is classically seen in systemic sclerosis. Okay, so let's see this picture. So, as I said, there can be a pterygium. So, what is this pterygium? Pterygium is a focal area. It's kind of a wing-shaped extension where the nail plate is lost and there is a band which starts from the proximal nail fold and then it starts from the proximal nail fold and then it gets attached to the nail bed. Okay. So, this is your pterygium. Now, please understand that pterygium is a permanent thing. Okay, you cannot reverse a pterygium. So if you see pterygium in one nail, it's important for you to understand that you need to treat the lichen planus more aggressively because it will give rise to pterygium in other nails. Okay, so once there is a pterygium already formed, you can't do much about it. This is another picture of nail lichen planus, which is showing you the presence of thinning of the nails, which is the most classical and the most common presentation of nail lichen planus. So you can see there is thinning of the nails. In addition, what you can see is longitudinal striations. So there is vertical striations or longitudinal striations. What else can you see? You can see there is onycholysis. The nail has got separated from the underlying nail bed, right? So you see there is onycholysis. What else do you see? You see that there is the tenting of the nail plate because of a papule of lichen planus which is situated on the nail bed. So this sign is called as the pup tent sign. Okay, so that's called as the pup tent sign. So, what are the features of nail lichen planus? In nail lichen planus, you can see the presence of thinning of the nail. You can see longitudinal striations. You can see the presence of subungual hyperkeratosis at times. You can see onycholysis. There is a pup tent sign which is positive. There can be vertical melanotic bands, and you can also appreciate that there can be longitudinal melanonychia. Okay, and the classical change of nail lichen planus is pterygium formation. So as you can see, it's a wing-shaped extension that started off from the proximal nail fold, getting attached to the distal end of the nail. Okay, next is, yeah, this is another picture showing you thinning, longitudinal splitting, pterygium formation of the nail plate along with subungual hyperkeratosis. Okay, this is a beautiful picture, onychoscopic picture of the pterygium, where you can see this wing-shaped extension actually coming and joining to the nail plate, causing complete loss of the nail plate at times. Okay, so dorsal pterygium is the most classical feature. This is your pup tent sign. So you have a papule of nail lichen planus on the nail bed, and that papule is causing the elevation of the nail plate. So this is called as the pup tent sign. Okay, this is 20 nail dystrophy. As I mentioned to you, 20 nail dystrophy can happen in patients with alopecia areata, psoriasis, as well as lichen planus. The exact etiology can sometimes be made clinically when you see the characteristic findings. Like if you see multiple nails showing pterygium, it is suggestive that it is lichen planus. Okay, when you see regular pitting and sandpaper nails, it is more suggestive of alopecia areata. When you see irregular pitting, you see subungual hyperkeratosis, onycholysis, it is more suggestive of psoriasis. Okay, so 20 nail dystrophy can have many causes, but the most common cause of 20 nail dystrophy is alopecia areata. Okay, now let's go to the last question that we'll be discussing today. An HIV positive patient presents with nail infection caused by fungal invasion of the nail plate. Which of the following cannot cause this nail infection? Trichophyton, epidermophyton, microsporum, or candida? Anyone? Yes, so Santrupt, Krishna, Tina, Amrit, Ujjwal, Sunshine, Kartikeya, Mullai, you're wrong, but I think Divya, everyone is correct. The correct answer is microsporum. Yes, Amrit, you are very right. M does not involve N. So microsporum does not involve the nails. Okay, and epidermophyton does not involve the hair. E does not involve H, and M does not involve N. Okay, so the correct answer here is microsporum. Very good, Mullai. Okay, so it does not in M does not involve N. That is what you need to remember. So superficial infections affect the epidermis, mucosa, nail, and the hair. Most of these superficial infections are caused by dermatophytes. Non-dermatophytes such as Candida and Pitrosporum also produce skin infections. So Trichophyton will involve skin, hair, and nail. Microsporum will involve the skin and the hair, but never involves the nail. Epidermophyton involves the skin, rarely nails, but never involves the hair. Okay, so this you need to remember. Can anyone tell me what is the presentation of onychomycosis in an HIV positive patient? What is the presentation? Like if you see that kind of onychomycosis, then you should be doing an HIV testing for that patient. What is that variant of onychomycosis which you more commonly seen in HIV positive patients? Anyone would like to tell me the answer to this question? What are the types of onychomycosis? See, onychomycosis literally means that there is fungal infection of the nail plate, okay, of the nail. So the onychomycosis can be either a dermatophytic onychomycosis where you have involvement with the trichophyton or epidermophyton, or it could be a non-dermatophytic onychomycosis, which can be caused by Candida, sometimes can be caused by Aspergillus, can be caused by Acrimonium species as well. So that is non-dermatophytic onychomycosis. Okay, Now, please understand that if you, when we are talking about dermatophytic onychomycosis, there are various variants of dermatophytic onychomycosis. Okay, so the variants include distal and lateral subungual onychomycosis, which is most common. Then comes proximal subungual onychomycosis. Then comes superficial white onychomycosis. And then comes the total dystrophic onychomycosis and the endonyx variant. Now, can someone tell me which of these variants is more common in the HIV positive individuals? Is it DLSO, PSO, WSO, TDO, or endonyx? Anyone? Can anyone tell me? Okay, so the correct answer here is proximal subungual onychomycosis as well as white superficial onychomycosis are two variants that you classically see in HIV positive individuals. So if you do see any of these variants, it's important for you to investigate the patient for any kind of immunodeficiency. Okay, so remember proximal subungual onychomycosis and superficial white onychomycosis are variants that you would expect in dermatophytic onychomycosis seen in HIV. Is that clear? So that's the time we have today. Thank you everyone for joining. I'll be back next month, that is in May, with my YouTube sessions, special classes, as well as my courses. So do join an academy. Do follow me on an academy so that you will be notified about all the special classes. And thank you very much. See you. Bye. Have a great day.